the issue of sanctions. For a very long time, it is unfortunate that the party that I used to belong in the MPC was selling us a dummy that sanctions are targeted, sanctions are because of human rights and all other things. And it took me time for me to be able to reach the executive leader, to read this data document, to find that sanctions are actually hurting our economy. I started doing my own comparisons, looking at other African states that are under sanctions, looking at other nations internationally that are under sanctions, and what happened to them. Sanctions actually divide a nation. Sanctions destabilize economies. Sanctions create hate between people. They push for regime change agendas where people get so much agitated to the extent that they'll do anything to remove a government from power. And after that government has been removed, it will all be chaos. We've got a perfect example in Libya of the effect of America intervention in any state. So for me, as I stand here today, I'm standing in solidarity with the president of this country, I'm standing in solidarity with the SADC heads of state, who decided to make a bold statement that enough is enough. We cannot continue leaving the Western imperialists to continue plundering and looting our resources, setting conditions for Africans that suit the way they want to govern the rest of the world. We are Africa. We've got a lot of homegrown solutions, and we should be allowed to take ownership of our natural resources. Zimbabwe is being used as an example that you do not take away the means of production from white people. We are Africans. The land in Zimbabwe belongs to Zimbabwe, and we are unapologetic about that. What we're just calling for right now is for the government of Zimbabwe to ensure that they do a redistribution of land that will favor all vulnerable groups, which are the people living with disability. That will also favor women who are economically disenfranchised. That will also ensure that the youth in Zimbabwe are empowered, because about 90% of youth in Zimbabwe are unemployed. That is my clarion call. Beyond the sanctions mantra that we're going on in, it was a positive and first move from African head of states in SADC to say we're going to stand in solidarity with Zimbabwe. After we are done with the sanctions issue, I also expect the SADC head of state to stand in solidarity with each other to ensure that we speak with one voice against corruption. Because as long as African countries are still practicing corrupt tendencies in their nations, Africa is not going to progress. And the America and European countries will always come back and play the big men politics and try and use us to divide us so that we are not effective and we can't move Africa from the third world status that it has. We have the potential, we have the brains. Instead of running away to other countries to look for money, let's start putting our minds to developing Africa, to save Africa from the time.